What's up, guys? Funk with you with the love of reading, and I'm back after a break. My computer was out for repairs, and I read the whole ton. That's why I haven't uploaded recently. But I've got three books that I want to go over with you quickly here. The first thing I've got is The Two Towers. I finally finished The Two Towers by J.R.R. Tolkien. You know, it's been really interesting for me. I, at the age of 36, had never heard the story of The Lord of the Rings. Late last year, I read The Fellowship of the Ring. I just completed The Two Towers, and I'm looking forward to The Return of the King. I don't know what's going to happen because I never saw the movies when I was younger. I did watch The Two Towers movie after I finished the novel. Thought it was really good, and I think you guys are going to find this interesting if you haven't seen this already. This is called The Lord of the Rings and Philosophy, One Book to Rule Them All. It's a series of essays by a variety of authors on this book, but I'm not going to read it yet because I don't want to spoil the ending of The Return of the King. The next one I've got for you is called KL, A History of the Nazi Concentration Camps by a historian named Nicholas Waxman. This is a book that's quite different from the other concentration camp history books that I've read. I've read more than several concentration camp survivor memoirs. Those are always haunting but good reads that give us a glimpse into a particular camp from a particular inmate's perspective. This book, however, is an all-inclusive account that takes us from before the war, from before the KL system was created. It talks about the influences that went into the creation of the camps, all the way through to the liberation of Auschwitz and even beyond what happened after the war. And I found it a really, really dark but psychological and philosophical history book. This may be the only broad account of the KL system overall, and I found it to be a really good read. I gave it a 5-star rating. It's one of the best history books I've ever read, and not only did I learn about the camp system and the nightmare that it was for so many people, but I learned about it from the perspective of an inmate and the perspective of a guard and the governing body and the society as a whole. And I also learned about the war in general. I learned a lot about Hitler and Himmler and everything that went into the Nazi concentration camps. I found it a very valuable book, a hard read, but an engrossing read nonetheless. One more to mention, guys. I'm going to be quick about this one because I'm going to be doing a whole episode on the program here very soon about this story. This one is by a British astrophysicist named Alastair Reynolds. It's called Galactic North. And it's a book of short stories that takes place in the Revelation Space universe. Revelation Space is a series of books that center on a trilogy that are a hard science fiction space opera type story, a deep space kind of thing. I absolutely love it, and it ends chronologically with Galactic North. I thought that this was a really good book, but I'm going to save my thoughts overall for the upcoming episode on Revelation Space. I'm also reading two nonfiction books now. I'm listening to the audiobook and reading the text simultaneously with these. One is called Beyond Order, 12 More Rules for Life by the Canadian clinical psychologist Jordan Peterson. It's a self-help book, the second in a series. I read the first one last year. It's called 12 Rules for Life. I thought it was good. Did not review it then, but I'll review both of the books, 12 Rules and 12 More Rules, here in the near future. You know, I disagree with Jordan Peterson on some things. However, I find him very, very knowledgeable about other things, and I like to challenge myself by reading authors that have a different perspective than I do. So I'm looking forward to reviewing both of his books soon. And I'm also reading a book called Mindfulness in Plain English by an author's name who I won't speak here, but I'll put an image on the screen for you. Recently, as I've been trying to better myself, I decided to write down a list of things that I've avoided in the past that are just hard for me. And meditation and mindfulness are two of those things. So I'm finally going to do it, guys. And because I'm a reader, because I learn best by reading, I'm going to read this book. It's not very long. It's maybe 150 pages or so, a little over 4 hours in the audiobook format. And I'm about a quarter of the way through it, and I'm really enjoying it. So hopefully this book finally gets me into meditation. And there you have it, guys. I'm doing some fiction. I'm doing some nonfiction. I've got to review the books that I've talked about today. There's a lot of catching up to do here. I've got some interviews I'm going to be doing. There'll be a lot to come here in the next couple of weeks on my channel. Thanks for joining me, guys. I'll see you next time. Let me know what you're reading down in the comments below.